How many of you, including me, have a frumpy looking couch like this in your RV that you just can't wait to get rid of? Tans and darker tans and even slightly darker tans and shades of gray. You don't really know how to do it though. And you also don't want to spend a ton of money on a new couch. Well, I got just a solution for you. I'm going to show you how to do it. Here we go. The good news was when I bought this RV, everything was spectacularly clean in here. That goes for this couch too. No funky odors or smells, no nasty stains, nobody died on this couch and then their body liquefied into the cushions. Don't laugh. I saw it on an RV that I looked at. It looks like so much else in this RV. Like this wall covering, I don't like that either. That's gonna go too. Now, I looked at some couches at Camping World and other larger RV retailers, and they're expensive. They want a lot of money for one of these things. And the space that we have here to work with is 68 inches. I had to find something that fits into that space. Typically, it falls into the love seat category. So it had to be under 68 inches. I found a couch that is 66 and a half inches, I believe, total width. This happens to be a sofa bed. Nice sheet, I guess. Not only did nobody die on the couch, nobody died on this mattress either. The couch is screwed down, it looks like, back here. Let me show you where it's anchored, or where it seems to be anchored. Maybe we'll take the bed, the whole metal piece out of here. Another thing that I found annoying by this particular couch is this whole thing down here would be great for storage. And I've got some electric scooters that I want to take along on trips. So the new couch is going to be raised up a fair amount. We'll hopefully have enough storage underneath it to accommodate the scooters. So let's start tearing this thing apart and getting it out of here so we can get the new couch in. All right, so the brackets are out and now the couch is like shimmying around in here. All right, so these are the things that are holding the bed frame in place. It's like a square drive screw. I've already done the other side. Came out pretty easily. There's about four screws. A little bit of a tight fit. That's it. All right, sweet. So we've got this whole thing. Let's see if we can kind of fold it back together. Let's make it small. Cool. Well, that's out. But right now, I just want to get this piece of crap out of here. I don't know if this is going to go out the door, quite frankly. Wow. There is no way that that couch is going to fit out that door. I'm going to have to do some serious demo on this thing. Oh, I just figured it out. This thing apparently detaches, and I think that's gonna be the key to getting the rest of it out. Oh, that was so promising. Look at that. I'm so close. I gotta see if I get these armrests off. Right here, there's like this much more couch right behind here. I think these side pieces are held on with a couple screws right there. And if I can bust these side arm pieces off, then the thing will come out. Yeah, I'll show you on the bottom one. Your couch may be different, but these armrests are likely simply connected via these screws. Moment of truth. Will it disconnect? Sure will. All right, now I'm just gonna flip this thing over and do the other side. All right, so for those of you new to my channel, I do a lot of videos on RVs and I do a lot of videos on tiny houses. Now, I own an RV, this one, and I own a tiny house. And I'm all about sort of like a minimalist lifestyle. It's really about kind of taking this RV from being just kind of this plain vanilla box that it is and turning it into something cool. If you like this video, please consider giving it a thumbs up. But I make a lot of this content. Check out my other stuff, please. And one more piece of the couch. I'd be super surprised if this does not fit out the door. As with most things, that was a little bit harder to do than anticipated at first. All I'm gonna do is clean this up a little bit. There are back here seatbelt hitch points, by the way. That is the windshield cover. I did a separate video on that before. You can check out that video right up here. Here's my main reason for buying this. It was the right size. It's the right material, which is a faux leather. I'm gonna drop a link to this particular piece in the description below. Do not open with sharp objects. I like to live dangerously. It's not that sharp. This is how things get smuggled. These are the front legs, and they're kind of like, they're kind of like off center there. See that? All right, this looks to be a dead simple process. You have these two holes here. You have another two over here. All right, that's one. Comes with a nifty little Allen key. Try not to bust the legs off of this thing as we do this. Yeah, it should be all right. That's all right. Oh yeah. So I don't know if you could see that, but right down here, that foot is just kind of right off the edge. But that makes for a pretty good sleeping space. But for now, that's pretty cool. You got your cup holders right here. You know what? It's not too bad. It's not the world's most comfortable couch. I guess I could sleep on it like this. Yeah. I mean, if I folded the back down, definitely. It's a little cramped. I mean, I'm 6'3". I don't know, that works for me. Well, that's a big change. I'd say it's an improvement. When it's pushed back like that, you got a little bit of, you don't have that armrest messing you up. You can watch TV over here. Got your beer. Got your beer right there. All right, so we went from this to this. And I'd say that's a big improvement. So let's decorate it up a little bit because, you know, it's kind of plain looking. Granted, there's a lot of work left to be done in here, but this is a really nice start. Now we got to get rid of these stupid things on the windows. We got to paint in here, but if I can get more of a look like this in here, I'd be super happy. Cat pillows, got to have cat pillows. These are made out of old retired sweaters, but look at that. Look at the personality on that thing. If you think this has been an improvement, let me know in the comments. If you think I should have done something differently, let me know that as well. But for now, I'm gonna sign off and say goodbye and see you next time. Mm-hmm.